She didn't even have to ask. She just touched and it happened. Because Jesus is all powerful. That power that was wrapped up in him, he shared it with her and it healed her. You know, God wants to share his power with all of us. But we cannot have that power unless we receive Jesus as our Savior. We realize our sin, and then we become his child by asking him to save us. Now let me give an illustration about power. Don't worry, we will send you back, but since you met Jesus, I think you'll appreciate this too.
What is that?
Oh, it's a vacuum cleaner. It sucks up dirt. Now, I love pretzels. I like to crush them too and make messes. Oh. Don't say anything. I am creating myself a very big problem right now. This is a big mess. This is a really big mess. It could. But it's gonna be cleaned up. But luckily, no, sit back. I've got a way to clean up a mess. Because messes can really be messy. And if you have a mess and no way to clean it up, you could have a problem. Listen, if you're here and Jesus is not your Savior, you've got a problem. You need God's power to clean it up. So let's vacuum up this mess. What's wrong? Why isn't this working? Oh, this! What's this? What do you do with this?
Plug it.
And what's it do?
Gives it power.
Who said that? Gives it what? Power! Can't work the machine without power. So, go ahead and plug it in right over there. Actually, right there. That's even better. All right, it's plugged in. You see the power? You feel the power? Let's go.
Turn it off.
Wait.
Turn what?
Turn off.
Oh, how do I do that? With this switch? So, listen, I have to actually press this switch and turn it on in order for it to work. So I have to tap into the power to turn on. Or maybe I should just try doing this a little while longer. Maybe it'll work.
No.
Alright. Okay. Now listen to that. Feel that power. Alright. Power and see the